try to do both sides. For those more experienced tango dancer, that helps out. And also to the enrosque. That's what we call front enrosque. That's what we do it all, back enrosque. See? That's all those exercises help us to do that way. Okay? Now we have to do is soft the knee and just put this knee behind the other one. See? There it is. And plie. And this here. And now when I go is I walk compressed and stop. Now if you have to move exactly. If you move this, it's not gonna work. We need to compress. Compress, bam. Compress.
Eso. So you work against me, okay? So we're gonna take a side step. And now we're gonna apply this exercise and be alone together. We wanna but keep the compression in here. And people. And again. Go. And people. So now before it was one hand against the other, now it's one person against the other. So the heel is really working like you were doing this exercise alone and now it's together. I'm going backward, he's going forward. And again. And now, if we, when in this moment I take my shoulders away, we lose the connection. So it's very important to keep that expansion.
Now, from where we start the momentum to turn and in her back step. See her back, back step, and we end it. See, that's what we use. Her back step, she's gonna do back side forward step. And when I send her to go in her back step, I keep moving people, and when she goes forward, that's the moment I land. But this side I keep people, okay? Go back. Here. No, she's gonna go here, we'll rotate your heels. One, two, three. See, it's all the same idea.
And try to stay together into the circle as much as possible.
Is that clear? Rock and roll.
Hello, you're stronger inner thighs. Why we're having a hard time now to pivot is because we have this big muscle, the quadriceps, who we're using a lot because it's stronger. We're saving so much lower back problems and knees problems. Now, when you practice that, you can even do it on the chair. You don't need to be on the floor. You can sit on the chair and do it. It works out well. The most important is you have to concentrate it in that point of support.
Time is going to be like this. We're going to use a training position. And now, we're going to get it. In tempo, we have two ways to shift the balance. That first of all, that we call parallel. The balance here, those two legs are free, and then back again, free, yeah? And then we call cross system balance. When I pick her balance in her left, and I go to my left. That's free, and it's free. See, that means parallel, we go like this, in cross system. When I play her balance in whatever size he wants, I go a little bit around. Now, if you turn her too much, she's gonna take a step. See? And that's what we're looking for. Exactly that. We place our balance in cross system, and now we get the ratio, she's gonna pivot, and I will pivot myself too. And we're gonna go back, side, forward, side. Back, side, forward. See? Both sides with the same idea.
The most common thing is when we do this exercise, we get it from people, this is the connection. And we are trying to really work against each other so we can really pivot and keep that center. So you need to use that concept of working against each other.
Back, side, forward, side.
You try to move the hips and maintain the shoulders. You don't move the hips and take the shoulders with you. That way, the voice stays there.
Two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Now, if you need to walk at the 4B, we'll be like this. One, two, three, four. two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Now we're gonna take one and three.
Sin aurora.